All right, in this video, we're going to go ahead and create a statement to send out to our customers who have not paid on time or who we want to send out reminders to. So we're going to create statements here. So you go up under Customers, Create Statements, okay? So you have a whole bunch of different options here on the statements. You can make a certain statement date. We're going to make it as of last month. You can have a certain period, so from the beginning of the month to the end of the month, okay? And you can have all open transactions as of the statement date. So what this is going to say, and I'll show you what this means. So the statement period is from 4/1 to 4/30. If I go ahead and preview this, all right, see how it says balance forward as of 3/31. So they didn't have any activity in April. So all it's going to show on here is balance forward. But if I choose all open transactions as of statement date and preview, now it's going to show me the detail. Okay. And the date. So this is from back in December. All right. And then you have the option to include only transactions over 30 days past due. So if you are only creating this statement to really get them to pay those super old bills, you can do it for all customers, select customers, one customer, filter by customer type, and also by preferred send method, okay? But we're just going to stick with all customers for now. And then, of course, you can view the selected customers, too, if you're choosing multiple. Okay, you have a template that you can use. It comes with a standard, you know, Intuit template, but then, of course, you can customize it. All right, it's not going to let you customize the original that they give you because they always like to keep that one just as is. And you can come in here and, you know, change things around if you want to say month. Oh, my goodness. My fingers were off. Monthly statement, you can do that. Okay. You can change the columns if you want to. You want to have the item included in there. And we want it to be under... Okay. You can have the balance in there, quantities, rates. You can add some additional things there. So you can have an additional footer if you want to. Right now it says amount due. You can change that to say due immediately. All right. And then how you'd like to print it. Then, of course, it has basic customization, so you can add your logo and all that fun stuff, and the layout designer, so you can drag and drop boxes around and change things as you prefer them to be changed. Okay. So that's what the statement designer looks like, and of course, it's very similar to designing other templates that we have. So you're going to choose the statement that you want to use. Do you want to create a statement per customer or per job? All right. Show the invoice details on the statement. So you want the details by item. This is, do you want to print the statements by billing address zip code? So it's just a way to filter them. Do you want to print the due date on the transactions? That's probably a good idea. And then don't create statements for people with a zero balance, with a balance less than a dollar maybe. Because if you have a couple people in there with a penny outstanding, you know, you don't want to create a statement for them with no activities or for inactive customers. You might want to uncheck that because if you have some inactive customers that owe you some money, you want, this is a good way to get that, to find that out. So then you can also assess your finance charges here, which we go into in another video. So I'm going to go ahead and just preview these statements. Notice how changed monthly statement due immediately. You can see here I have invoice number 2 and it has the breakdown of what this invoice is. So I can go to the next page and I see another invoice here. Let's see who this is for. This is for Renee Barley for $525. It says the original invoice date was 1/11. It was due 1/26. So we have all this information here, and then at the bottom, of course, it does tell you, you know, what's current, 30 days, 60, 90, and then what's due immediately because it's already past due. Okay. So that is how you create a statement to send out to your customers.